Hi guys, Potato McWhiskey here, and welcome back to Let's Play Civilization 6, Island, Japan. We're playing on Emperor and Chill, guys. Emperor and Chill. Let's get back into things. I think we had just finished a turn. I think we had actually changed our government in a little bit of time. Yeah, we had the Trade Confederation and the plus hammers in all cities. So we're going to want to be cracking out as many of these commercial hubs and stuff as soon as possible. I was getting ready also for a push into Sumeria. Also, this city state's health has just gone up crazily. Just out of nowhere, it just skyrocketed. What? We're going to push into them anyway to see what we can do. Let's see. In the capital city, we will be building... Probably not much. We're going to be grabbing a trader here. It's probably the best move I can do. Grab a trader. And we're going to be sending our trade routes internationally just for the fun of it. I'm going to be dropping a campus. Or should I get the industrial hub up? New. We'll drop the commerce hub first. Get the trade route. I'm going to be choosing production over here. All right, so you have... some of your tiles in good order. Do you want to build a builder? Let me have a look here. I do not have the plus builder charges policy, so I want to be careful about that. Why don't you do me a flavor? Do me a flivy-flav. And, it's a hard choice here. Commercial hub. I think we go for the harbor first. Yeah, harbor first feels good to me. The spearman can rest, as can the chariot, as can the scout, as can the builder can do something else for me. Let's see. We're not working that tile. I could put a lumber mill here. I think what I will do is I will put a mine here, and then I will chop there. And that's going to be the end of the turn, so let's move on here. Boom, next turn. Oh, unit needs orders. I hate it when it does that. I hate it. It really bothers me. I hate it that it tells me it's my next turn, but it's not actually my next turn because there's a unit that needs orders. Why don't you just tell me the unit needs orders and not deceive me? Jesus. All right. Not quite ready. I have one more crossbow that I would like to upgrade, so that's another turn away before I move out with these units. Let's get you in position. Just alert and alert. We're going to be building samurais to follow up this push. Sleep here. Sleep here. Unit needs orders. Oh, next turn you'll have to move there. You should just go on auto-explore. Really? He went from the city to the future harbor to the future commerce tile. Okay. What? I don't know what to say. I really don't. I really don't know what to say. I'm at a loss for words. I really am. I'm at a loss for words. Oh, when it has a unit in it. I need to get there and not let a unit get into it. It's still quite strong, however. Unit needs orders. Wait there. Move there and chop that out. I'll be putting probably a district on this sheep tile. Progress towards recorded history has advanced considerably. Choose production. You have finished what? You finished a campus. That's excellent. We're going to be picking up some other stuff here. Huh. So I'm not really sure what I'm going to do. 33 turns. This feels like a really, really long amount of time. This city needs other things to happen in it before I can do that. Especially it needs tile improvements big time. But I don't have a builder policy slotted in. I will be able to slot in that builder policy soonish though. What if I were to pick up a builder here? When could I slot that in? I could probably slot it in place of... Excuse me, I have the hiccups. I could probably slot it in. Actually, you can't build builders. You're you get builders sent to you from another city. Instead, you're going to build a water mill, and I'm going to build a builder in Kyoto. I'm actually going to stop this here. Next turn, I'm going to try and remember to stop that. Okay, we have almost all of the units we need to move out. We're taking two swordsmen, two caravels, and two crossbowmen, and that's what we're hoping to push into Nippurdu with. We're going to land a swordsman and a crossbowman here, and a swordsman and a crossbowman here, and have two caravels up here. That's the goal. Oh my god, what is Russia doing over here? Russia, this is such an aggressive settle. In fact, I could kill that for free and then have a land land way onto this island. We'll see about if we do that. Actually, something I need to be careful about is that there's nowhere to settle on my land. Otherwise, people are going to like drop a city here that I'll have to kill ultimately. We shall see. Okay, we have a crossbowman. Now, let's have a little think here. Okay, end your turn. End your turn. Unit needs orders. I just ended your turn already. Builder, actually, I want you to remove that. And then I want you to pick up a oracle. Oracle could be a fun one, but we don't need it right now. I could drop it on the sheep. That would be a good use of the sheep. You have a builder. You don't need a builder. You really need growth in terms of your housing. So it might actually make sense to get a lighthouse here to get that plus one housing. I could also get an aqueduct. That would be a lot of houses. Yeah, I think an aqueduct here. We kill a hill. We get a district adjacency bonus. Get some housing. Do it. Send this trade route to Udik. I would like to send it to him, but I can't afford to send it there. You could send it to Amsterdam, but Amsterdam is in the way, isn't it? Yeah, no, I can't. What about Valletta? Valletta is safe. Brussels, Fortezella. I don't really have very good trading partners right now, aside from Sumeria, but I don't want to trade with Sumeria. So I might just trade with a, like, Hong Kong or something. Or maybe Valletta. Valletta's a good choice too, because it's nearby, it's safe. Okay, so we have a medieval fairs completed, which means we can change this. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually swap this out and put in builder production. I think that's best right now. And I could use more gold, but I would prefer to have the envoy influence. Actually, let's try out the gold. Let's see how that feels. Let's see how gold feels. From envoys. We're going to put in two more into Geneva to get that little bit of extra science. My last omnibus playthrough, I didn't get a single scientific city-state, which was pretty sad, actually. Okay, this city needs a builder sent to it. We're going to need a lot of builders pretty soon to really fill out our land and get it productive. Now, you have your thing, but you're going to need something else. And that something else is probably some tile decisions. Let's have a little bit of a think here. Okay, well, you're going to need a harbor, and we can put the harbor pretty much anywhere we want. So we could do, like, how about we could put the harbor here. And it just renamed a random thing. Like, this is not a harbor. This is a campus game. Am I supposed to hit enter? What am I supposed to do to make it do the thing I wanted to do? It just won't do it. Harbor. Boom. Again. Again, it swapped this one. What do I do to fix you, game? Honestly. Okay, harbor. And then we'll put a campus here. And, oh. Yeah, it did it for once. Campus. And then we will add a pin here. Commerce. Okay, so that's the harbor, commerce, campus. Which are the three main districts, I feel like. Maybe an industrial district every now and again, but the harbor campus commerce are like the boom, the three big. But the harbor commerce campus are like the three big ones that we want to make sure we get. I don't care about a holy site encampments. Who cares about those? Entertainment district actually would be a good one to get somewhere. Mainly just for adjacency bonuses reasons. So we want to put those probably beside things that get adjacency bonuses. Now, in terms of what we're going to build first, you need a builder, but you also need growth. Yeah, you just need a builder to get to you. So I might just make a granary and get you growing a little bit more aggressively. I guess it's time to start moving out with these units. We're going to move our ships tentatively over here. This swordsman can go over here. The crossbowman can follow suit. This guy can go here. Wait, is there a special property of caravels? Why did these guys have three movement on the water? That's very interesting, and I'm curious to know why. Okay, you have three things left. Now, what tiles are you working? Primarily these. I am going to need another productive tile. I think it's going to be this food over here. Okay. I'll have a little farm triangle and maybe another district or something. We'll see how we figure things out. Try to fit the land around the things. We're not doing unit upgrades, so let's switch over to unit maintenance. Okay, and we have now been ready to go for exploration. Okay, as much as I would love to start producing useful things in this city to help it out, I think it needs to help the other cities. I need to pump infrastructure. I need like a builder here, a builder here, a builder here, a builder here. I need like 1, 2, 3. I need 4 builders in my empire somewhere. And they need to be quick. You should make another one. You're 5 charges, okay. We can make a lumber mill, so let's get this fish online first. Let's go to Gdansk here, I think, just to get the trade thing, the thing that lets you extend your trade range. Ideally, I would be trading with Sumeria, but that's just not an option right now. You're going to go to... Arma 9. Do not go to Arma. Go to Gdansk. The Gdansk trade route is so terrible, though. Go to Arma. Arma is not good either. I just don't have very good choices. I don't want to go to Amsterdam because it's not a safe trade route. Is there like a short trade route you could just pull off for a few turns? Yeah, do this quick little dirty trade route for a little while. Sneak in over here. Don't get too close. Next turn we move out. My units just have 3 movement for some reason in their ships. That's odd. That's very odd. I'm not used to that. Okay, just wait up here. They have a caravel of their own. Build a farm. Excellent. Oh my god, Valletta, calm yourself. The question here is, Sumeria is not the suzerain of any of these city-states that I care about. All right. You go there alone. Next turn, we declare the war. We drop a fishing boat there. And also, so you're now working that farm, right? Excellent. These are all great tiles for you. Go harvest that sheep. He's still building war carts. That's a good sign for me. War carts are not very good at this stage in the game. And now... you're going to build a granary. You're going to build an entertainment complex, probably. But you're going to build a granary. Because you need to grow. And you need a builder. and you need a trader, and you need all sorts of things that will eventually get to you. Let us declare war. Declare surprise war. Boom. Go there. Go there. Hoping to get him over there. We'll see what we can pull off. Major defeat. We don't want to be attacking just yet. Go there, be ready to jump up there and shoot. Oh, I could attack with two units. Boom. Boom. He should take 18 damage. He took extra damage somehow. How did this ship take more damage? What? How did this ship take more damage? How did this ship take more damage? What is happening? How is that possible? The game does not explain that to you. It just has these random rules that don't get explained. Yeah, you think you're a warmonger. I don't care what you think of me. This ship has 53. This ship has 52. They should have similar levels of health and stuff, but they don't. Major victory. Okay, we're gonna attack here. Do I attack with the caravel? Yeah, I suppose we're doing a quick slam attack, so we want to hit them hard and fast. They think you're a warmonger. Yep. Don't care what they think. I want to shoot here, and then I want to push past so that I have the city under siege. Then I want to shoot the city. Okay, I'm trying to think about what my next move is, because I want to be careful, because they have a caravel here. And I'm going to actually, I should have brought these units to follow up the attack. Because, actually, this guy could get upgraded, right? Yes, you could. Okay, this builder is going to be headed over to Osaka. And then just make another builder. Yeah, you're going to make me the lumber mill, and then you have three charges left, so you can go to Nagano. So all of these tiles are now improved. The city is pretty happy at the moment. Doesn't really have any growth in it, but it's making another builder, which is good. It'll take some of the pressure off my other cities. Problem. We're trying to get a little bit of experience to try and survive this hit and this shot. Now, we're gonna hit this city to do some damage. We're gonna harvest the sheep and grow this city up a little. Then we're also going to come over here and look for any units that could use upgrades. Next turn I'll be able to, no, two turns. Okay, excellent, we got promotions. Oh my god. Barbarian island over here. They don't have any farms to pillage, unfortunately. So you're going to get a level up here, plus 7 combat strength versus naval units, and that should win you this fight then. Okay. You're gonna move a tile and rest. You're gonna continue to shoot the city to keep wounding it. You're gonna skip your turn. We're gonna wait one more turn and then we're gonna upgrade some of these units and send them over. Did I unlock knights? I didn't. That's not very good. Okay, so I don't really have any options for this unit other than fortify. Wait here. Soon you will be fine. So I was expecting to lose that unit, which is fine, and then I'm gonna kill here.
We shall not cease from exploring.
So kill here. Great. Now we're gonna start hitting the city real hard. You're going to fortify. Now we can choose our civic, which means we can quickly go up to privateers is something we're going to want to get. But let's grab the recorded history, which will give us 100% Kappa's adjacency bonuses, which is something we're going to maybe think about plugging in. But we want to get to extra trade route things. And where was it? Was it diplomatic service? No, it was... Guilds? No. Civil service? No. One of these technologies gives trade route yields. Yeah, here it is. Mercantilism. That's the one we're going to want to pick up. Okay, we have a new government. I think we're obviously going to pick Merchant Republic. So we have newly built builders, have two extra build actions. I think we're also going to take the... gold from trade routes. I think that's a pretty decent one to get us extra gold. I would also like the unit upgrade discounts. And what else could I do? Housing, tile cost, purchasing. No, this is going to be fine. This feels pretty decent to me, actually. Okay. So we're making quite a hefty chunk of gold now. And we can upgrade probably a caravel. Yeah, okay. We can probably upgrade a caravel, a pikeman. And I had an archer here. Not quite enough gold, but I'll get him up here. And then we'll upgrade him next turn. And we're probably going to also have a little bit of a look here. Can I purchase samurai? There's 610 gold, which is pretty crazy in my opinion. They're prohibitively expensive. These jungle tiles, I feel, don't do a whole lot for me, but I will improve this one. One more turn until that. So where are you growing to? 11 turns until border growth. That's not very good, if you ask me. Why don't you just hang on? This builder has one more charge. Why don't you go sit on that wheat and hope for the best? Go back to automatic exploration. That's going to be the end of the turn. So I'm just hoping that I don't lose any more units over here for a little bit. So we just got a boost for something, but I didn't care. So I clicked off it real quick. Okay, these units are ready to promote. Now I could hit here. Now that would be very, very dangerous to hit here. So what I'm going to actually do is retreat and heal on these units and bring up a fresh caravel. Bring over this pikeman, level up this archer. And now we have another set of units ready to push in and carry on the fight. And we'll be also going for, actually I'd like to pick up knights here. How about you go for knights and then square rigging? Because I think we have some. Do I have a quadri remount here somewhere? I do. I have a couple. No! I didn't mean to click that button. I clicked the auto explore button by accident. I have one quadri ream. I would like to maybe squeeze out another one. You can get me in 12 turns. That's or 8 turns. How long is it going to take me? It's going to take me 4 turns to get here. Yeah, you can get a. You can grab me a quadri ream in the time it takes for me to get where I need to. Okay, you have the potential for a lot of growth right now. So how do I actually get you that growth? And I think the best way is probably through trade route. So I'm going to grab you a trade route so that you can go back to growing. Although you need amenities. An entertainment district here seems reasonable. Wait, let me count tiles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this would not reach it. But an entertainment district would not go amiss. And here is the same as anywhere. So let's drop an entertainment complex. Because I could use the amenities. A little short on amenities. Like, let's have a look here. Yeah, it's getting an amenity from luxury resources. A lot of my cities lack amenities right now. So I'm gonna have to pick up some amenities from somewhere. We'll get this gold from the plantation. And you're just going to wait here and bother me every turn until that tile is grown too. Actually, why don't you go over there and bother me there. Okay, we have another builder that we can send over to Nagoya. And I think that covers all the builders we're going to need. You can put a mine over there. I had another builder over here somewhere. He's already made it to Nagoya. So drop a farm there. Now Sendai, you also have an amenity problem, but you don't really have a way to solve it. I could have built an aqueduct with you. That's definitely potentially an idea. Not one I'm particularly behind though. You could grab me traders, although you could build me a 14-turn samurai. 14-turn samurai. My goodness. And that's like, this is one of my highest production cities. Alright, isn't it? Yeah, it's up there. It's definitely not a low production city. 14 turns to get a samurai. By the time I get it, it's going to be obsolete. This unit production thing. I'm genuinely tempted to go through, learn how to mod this game, and fix all these problems I find with it. That's my feeling right now. Get me a trader. It's the most sensible thing. Alright, so now I have done all of the infrastructure sort of obligations that this city has, and now it just needs to power. So get your granary, get your water mill, get all your stuff and power hard for the late game. Okay. There is an argument made for a... This city doesn't have very good production, but it has pretty okay growth tiles, so I think I will actually pick up a lumber mill there. So we're going to do some damage to this guy. Are you going to eat this and live? You will probably live if you eat that. You should kill here. That'll get you a promotion, which is what I was hoping for. Okay, so I have 2 units here available for the fight. Do a shot against that city. And another shot against the city. So you guys are now ready to promote, and I'll promote you next turn. You're healing and resting. You're going to want to get back into that city. You need to move along and get further onto the conflict. You need to get up into here. I'm going to drop a farm on this tile. And I'm going to ignore you pretty much for the rest of the game until this is finished doing what it's doing. Found a tribal hut over here with a galley. I think I'm going to bring these galleys home now. Yeah, make your way home. So we are going to be able to upgrade some more units pretty soon to keep pushing into Sumeria. There's a barbarian settler over there. So this is going to be a decisive victory. Excellent. This unit can move up and level up and be prepared for its push. We're going to take combat strength when Arrow Storm, I think. I think clearing out units is pretty important, but this one's going to take Garrison so that it can get the anti-city combat strength. I'm going to move up this Pikeman. Pikemen are pretty strong. We have another Caraval on the cards. Excellent. Let's get a Lumber Mill here. I think that's pretty reasonable in my opinion. Brings it to a 2-3 tile. Lumber Mill, Forests on River are pretty damn good. You're going to rest here. You're a little bit hurt. Now, I think what we need to do is actually talk about this city's tiles. The very first thing is the commercial hub. Well, the very first thing is the harbor, and the harbor would be better there, but it's a toss-up between these two tiles. Campus goes here or here, and this is the worst tile, so I think the campus goes there. And it just did that thing that it does to annoy me. I'm gonna put the campus there. Okay. I think, do I sacrifice making this a worse tile and then just throwing something different on here? I think I do, because this works out better for me in the long run, I think, by going down here and putting the campus here, the commercial hub here, and the harbor here, I think makes a nice sort of trifecta. So if I, like, because that way I don't have to use up the wheat tile trying to be efficient, so commerce. Harbor. I'm trying to get into the habit of using these pins to try and remind me. I think they're a valuable tool in sort of a civilization player's repertoire that is underutilized. We're already building a harbor here, so I can get rid of the harbor signifier. And similarly here, I'm going to have to make some decisions about this. I don't actually know if you can build a harbor on those tiles, and I don't think you can. So it's probably going to be like harbor, commerce, commercial hub. So let's drop pins for that actually. So campus, commerce, harbor. So let's do campus, commerce, harbor. And actually, I think I've been going on for a very, very long time. I'm probably going to have to cut some of this footage. It's been that long. But I want to thank you very much for watching. Oh, screen's going a little bit crazy here. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know I'm having fun playing this. If you want to see more episodes of this, make sure you subscribe to my channel and you will get notifications when the new episodes come out. If you would like to directly support my channel, please leave a like on the video. It helps my ranking on YouTube and gets me more visibility and other people get to see my stuff. And, you know, then my channel grows. If you want to give me direct feedback about this episode, please leave a comment. I love reading your comments. I love you all. Thank you very much for watching, and bye-bye.